And we are back. So yesterday I was able to get a basic aluminum mine factory set up, making the plates and the castings. So we're going to, and Mark V stuff is unlocked. So we're going to first off unlock a couple recipes. We have hazmat suits, I believe, to unlock. We have, I believe, the aeronautical engineering needs to be unlocked as well. And then we'll work on nuclear power. But nuclear power is going to be our, hopefully, our goal for today. But I know that we need to make a specific piece. The radio controllers or something to be able to unlock aeronautical engineering and get nuclear power started. So, first, I have to finish off some of the things I was working on yesterday off stream. I was trying to get it done before the stream started today, but I realized that I had backed myself into a corner because I was too tired and I couldn't figure out what I needed to do anymore. You guys will see when as soon as I get this going here. I was just trying to do simple reinforced iron plates so I could have enough of those and not have to worry about them anymore. But either I was trying to go too big or something, and well, you'll see here in a minute. So this is what I had been working on yesterday. Right now this is set up to produce somewhere around 1400 screws, and I need to set up I believe it's like 690 plates, which means I need, I think, another 10 more refineries. So that's what I'm gonna try to do right now is finish up this basic stuff that I was working on. There's a lot of math involved in this that probably was why I couldn't finish doing it yesterday, is because I was too tired to do all the math. So first things first, we'll just take a quick little gander at what I've been making here. We got roughly 700 screws being made on each floor. We got the refinery pushing out a bunch of the iron ingots. So I have to make some more refineries. I have to do some basic math here to figure out exactly how much I'm making. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Times 65 is 585, something like that. So I believe we only need 350 for this part. So we're making an extra 235 right now. So I'm gonna throw in the other refiners here. And then we'll go from there. So, oops, I'm not on soup. And I forgot that I had changed the settings back to see if the train still was causing problems. Oh, okay, it's still back on medium. All right, awesome. I don't need ultra cloud quality. All right. So Just run this real quick. So 60, I need 350 divided by 65 is 5.3. I'm just using a calculator now to make it easier on myself. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I only need up to here, let's just say 6. So what I should do is take this one down, take this one down. Okay. Inventory's full, so I gotta throw some stuff into a chest real quick. I should have one. Thought I had one out here. Guess not. Okay, so let's put some of this stuff in here. Okay, just need to make room. Okay. So that should be all the iron I need for that. So then I have 3. That's not gonna work, right? Do I need to push this back another one? Yeah. So that's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, I don't have motors, shoot. I swore I had some in a chest somewhere. Maybe they're on the train? Da, da, da. gotta figure out where I put. Keep putting just random chest places to hold inventory when it's full, and that's starting to backfire now. Probably should do one more to be on the safe side. Okay, so that's 11. Okay. Probably would have liked to push them back a little bit further. Yeah, let's do that. So they line up. Okay, so that can come forward just a little bit. Is that not far enough? Nope, not far enough. Okay, so I keep putting in the same spot. Maybe there. It's a little off, but that's better. Okay. There's the 8. I mean, this is a lot of work just for the reinforced iron plates, I know. I wonder why the frame rate is so bad right now. Well, just gonna have to deal with it, I guess. I need to see how much water they're producing. So I may have to increase that with these extra 8. Should grab some plastic. Okay, so this needs 35 per minute. That's 280 on this side, 385. For the 11 I'm using. So 560 total. Should be less iron than I'm actually producing, so that should be okay. Let me copy and paste all these. Did I do that right? Did I actually copy? Okay. All right, so Nope. Ugh, you stupid things. Need to see where this lines up. Okay, so there's the third one. Okay. Okay, they all have power now. They all have iron. They're all producing ingots. Okay, cool. So now, Let's see, it's 90 per minute for each 250. So we need 450. So we need 22 and a half. So 23. Of these. Where can we fit 23 of them? That is the real question. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and another 8 would be 24, right? Shoot. Missing cable.
think I'm out of cable, actually. Okay, I gotta take the train back. Okay, so once I get these 24 set up, I'll be making the plates and the screws that I need, and then I need to set up like 5 or 6 assemblers. Probably should do 6, and then I just need to add 2 more screws, so I can have 1500 even. I think that'd be easier than trying to do 1400. So if I do 6 of those, then I'm producing 90 plates per minute. Well, I just have to grab wire and make the cables myself. And since I'm here, I can throw in pieces I need for the aeronautical engineering. I can finish unlocking hazmat suits. And then I gotta start making those pieces there. The radio control units. Problem is I need casings. That's going to be an interesting setup. So I didn't actually accept that as a choice. Hey, Noana, how's it going? Cool, thank you for lurking. put those? Ah, there are the filters. Okay, hazmat suits unlocked.
Milestone reached. With the new hazmat suit and iodine-infused filters, you will be protected against uranium-based radiation.
Now I need cable. Which it looks like I'm not making enough of. Well, I'm glad I was able to be here for you while you're working. Been doing a couple of early morning streams because I know people can't always make it to my late night ones. And since people are usually working or taking their lunch breaks around now, I thought it might be helpful to have something to watch. I might do a little stream tonight later on because I unlocked Phasmophobia. And I know that game's super fun, so I may end up playing a little bit of that tonight, too. I have no cable over here or wire. Shoot. Oh, really? Well, hopefully your day's almost over then. I know it always sucks to work on the weekends. Okay, cool. Okay, well, what I need isn't over here, so I have to go back. I have a ton of copper being made over on the other side, so I'll just grab some from over there and then make all this cable I need by hand. may have to set up this train to just run casing, the aluminum casing over, so I can make the radio controller parts, since everything else is over there. So, let me drop some supplies off. I'll go grab the copper and make a bunch of wire, and then make a bunch of cable. Might be easier just to go to each machine and take it out. It'll let me select it. There we go. Okay, hopefully that's enough. Okay, so this can take a minute to make all this wire and cable by hand. Then I gotta figure out what to do with all the aluminum casing, how to get it to where I need it to make the receivers and stuff. I don't even know if I have room in my main factory for another setup to make those radio controllers. I wonder if it might just be easier to make it over here Then I'd have to set up oil for plastic and a bunch of other stuff. I don't know. It's the biggest issue is trying to figure out how to get all these high-end parts that need all these pieces that are all the way across the map. And I don't know why I thought that making these iron plates was going to be just a small little task. But here I am, making a big production of it, because I don't want to run out of plates anymore. And when I'm done here, I gotta check the recipe. Really? I thought it would be able to be changed to whatever. I'll have to look into seeing how to make it so that it can be. Since I'm sitting here making all these wires, let me look that up. There's got to be a way to set it up so that it can be viewed at different qualities. Oh, it looks like only Twitch partners have a choice. So I may have to stream at a lower quality just to make it more accessible. Let me see. I don't know if I can do that while my stream is active, though. Oh, no, I mean, it's a good point. I mean, I wanted to have it at 1080p because I figured, you know, quality was important to people and having the best viewing thing, but I didn't even think about, you know, the fact that most people are watching it on their phone. They don't really need the 1080p. So I'll have to maybe lower it. I gotta figure out if I can stream it at a lower frame rate or a lower quality and then record it at a higher quality so people on YouTube can just choose what they want. Oh, Twitch partner? Dude, I'm not even affiliate, so that's not something that I can even think of it of being, honestly. Like, to be a partner, I think you need like 75 average viewers, and I can barely even get one or two, so. So I'll have to probably mess with my settings after the stream tonight and see about getting, see if there's a way that I can stream at a lower quality and then record at a higher one. I mean, it's no big deal. I mean, it's the little things. I want people to have an enjoyable experience more than anything else. So if people aren't able to watch just because, if people can't watch my stream because the quality is too high, that's something I need to take into consideration. So I'm glad you brought it up. Is it not rotating? Do I gotta put these in after? In reality, I'm still pretty new to all this anyways, so I'm sure there's still a lot I gotta learn. Why won't it? Oh, are these backwards? Shoot. Oh, that's what I did wrong. Wait, no. It's supposed to outflow, so they gotta be mergers. Oh, did I put these ones in backwards? That's what I did wrong. Okay. I knew there was something. Okay, that lets me set all those up. Oh, I gotta set the settings for these two. pretty sure it won't be that difficult to actually change the quality settings, so. I don't know if I can go all the way down to 480, but I might be able to do 720 at least. I'll have to check and see what my system settings are like. Okay, so I need to somehow power all this stuff now. And I need to make sure... I'm making enough. Let's see. 90 per minute times 6 is 540. I need 27, so I'm 3 shy on these ones. Okay. That should let me produce the plates I need now. A little bit closer than I would like it, but I think that's all the room I have to work with. Okay, so I need to add 2 more of these. Cat is begging for food. Give me 1 second here so I can give my cat some food. All right.
I just need to add pieces on the end, link these up. How many per minute? 50, so that means I need a basic lift. Will do it. And then they need power. Okay, so that takes care of screws. Now I just gotta finish making the plates, and then I gotta put in 6 assemblers. I was debating whether or not I was going to get Hogwarts Legacy, since everyone seems to really like that game. But I don't think my computer's good enough to play it, so let's see what happens. I may have to get it on Xbox or something. But I got Phasmophobia because I know everyone has a blast playing that game. And I was tempted to do that today for this stream, but I figure if I'm going to play it for the first time, I should do it at nighttime for me so that, you know, I can get the true experience. Yeah, my best friend has it, and he says it's frickin' awesome. He says it's so good he almost missed work because he was up so late playing it. And I was like, it's very rare for him to get sucked into a game that hard, so... I was like, if it's that good, then I definitely should probably check it out. It's just unfortunate that I don't have a better computer. Oh, a bunch, man. Most of them up on my YouTube right now, but I did this fun game called Farthest Frontier. It's like a town builder game, and that was really interesting. It's still in early access, so, and it's relatively new, so it's, I got through it relatively quickly, but that was really fun to play. I did Craftopia for a while. Minecraft, because it's, you know, I've been playing Minecraft since it was like, there was only like four items that you could craft with, so that game has always been something I keep my eye on every now and then. Let's see. I did Raft. I played through the whole game of Raft. That was really good. Let's see. I've been playing a game that's on Xbox Game Pass called Autonauts, which is like essentially you like make a bunch of robots. And you use like basic programming instructions to have them, to automate them. So like you can tell them, you know, like basic like if else commands and stuff like that. And you set up a little program for each robot and have them do a bunch of stuff. So you can be like, I want you to harvest this rock as long as you have something in your hand. If not, then go grab another tool out of the chest or make these tools or whatever. And so that's a pretty interesting little game. I haven't played it on stream yet because it's a little tedious, but it's really fun. And let's see. I'm trying to think of what I've done recently. I play a lot of games, so it's hard for me to keep them all in my head.
Oh, I have Dyson Sphere on my computer, actually. That game is really fun to play. My computer lags out a little bit while playing that game, so I haven't really been able to enjoy it as much as I wanted to. I got to the point where I was building like the panels, like the basic panels for the Dyson Sphere to get power. I haven't streamed that one because it lags too hard. But yeah, that's a good game too. I also been playing 7 Days to Die. I played the crap out of it when it was on Xbox. But I just got it for my PC recently because they actually updated on PC. So there's like a lot more stuff that you can do with it on PC than you can on the Xbox. And that game's relatively fun too. If you like, you know, fighting off zombies and stuff. Well, how is Star Citizen? I've heard a lot of mixed reviews about that. Great when it works, yeah. That's basically what I've heard. That reminds me of what was that game? I played it so much and I don't remember the name of it. The one that had like a trillion worlds or whatever it was. No, not EVE Online.
Man, I cannot remember the name of it. It's like a... Yes, No Man's Sky. Thank you. That's the one. I played that a lot too. And in that same realm, Astroneer. You ever played Astroneer? That's a great little game. Yeah, I played No Man's Sky when it first came out, and they didn't have any like the base building stuff or any of that nonsense, so it got boring really fast. And then I went back and played it to get like the once they updated it with the building and got the freighters and all that kind of stuff. But it's still pretty much the same thing, so. And once you're a billionaire, like, it kind of loses what you can do in that game. But I thought No Man's Sky was pretty interesting. I ended up getting like an S-class alien ship and a bunch of S-class ships. But it ended up lacking in the end. I think if they had like all the building stuff and everything in the beginning, then it might have done a little bit better. But overall, I can't really complain all that much. It was still a relatively good game. In the end, after they added everything. It was super boring in the beginning. Okay, so all that's set up now. I need to put in the 6... whatchamacallit? Oh yeah, they're definitely all the same. I mean, it's broken up a little bit more now because they added, you know, like the outposts and stuff like that, but it's still basically every planet is exactly the same. There's no point of going to all the different planets. And now I have to figure out how to get all of these screws and stuff here. Oh, shoot. One of these has to go. Should have built one down below and one up top instead of just two more up top, because then I can't put all the screws on the same belt. Alright, it's gonna drive me bonkers, but I'll just have one off on the top and bottom. Just for the fact that I can only do 780 on a belt. Okay. So now we have 750 down below and 750 up top. Wonder if I should have them go the opposite way up top.
Wait, what? Oh, I put it in the wrong spot. Okay, that makes sense then. Okay, that screws for there. Oh, what did I just delete? Oh, the floor, that's not good. Oh, what was it lining up with? Nope. That's not right either. There we go. And then I need to flip these around so that they go the other way. I may have to disassemble those and reassemble those. For some reason, I don't think they're going to work. Oh no, they did. Okay, never mind. Oh, maybe it's because the screws were already on there, so I don't know if they did or not. Shoot. Well, we'll find out in a second. You kidding me? Land on the platform. Thank you. Then I need to do nope, that's not right. Okay, let's just make this easier on myself. Why won't you let me? Okay, it's gotta be this thing up here is facing the wrong way or something. Okay. As I thought, these are not properly connected anymore.
means it's the same on the other side. Oh. Okay, that's screws. So now I just need to bring the plates up. Might be easiest to do a merger on the top. Then that. Oh, is that too low? Shoot. Okay, let's see, how do I connect this? Oh, I never ran iron to this stuff. Okay. I should do it from here. Just turn these around, have these go the other way. Okay, that brings iron to the other side. Now I need to bring this down. Put a splitter here. Go there. There. Oh, why aren't these all set up?
Okay.
Hopefully that all is working now. So now I just have to set up the mergers for the top. For the done reinforced iron plates. That's not right. Whoa. Oh, the power. Duh. Okie dokie. Alright, that should be making all the stuff that I need. Now I need to run a line to a chest. Why won't you stack downwards? I mean, that's not right at all. Okay, cool. Alright. Reinforced iron plates are officially being made, I believe. Why are you so slow to get iron plates? Not getting enough iron? Don't tell me I did the math wrong on this. Oh, I did. I'm not making enough iron. This son of a gun. I need 810 ingots. Shoot. You know what? That's good enough. I'm making a lot. I'm not making the amount that I'm supposed to be making, but I'm making a lot, so whatever. I'll just get frustrated if I keep trying to deal with that, so I'm gonna leave that be for now. And now I gotta figure out how to make
these things. Can I make that in an assembler? No, it has to be a manufacturer. Okay, so that means I do have to bring the aluminum casings over to the main factory. Somehow. Bring this over to the station, try to figure this out. So I think I'll have to ship them by a train from this station to the main factory, because I'm not sure exactly how to do that otherwise. These stations aren't finished yet because I need to get the one at the main factory set up like this one. Alright, I need to take a quick break, go to the restroom, go change my kid's diaper, so I'll be right back.
Alright, I'm back. Sorry that took so long. Kid was kind of fighting me, didn't want me to change her diaper. Man, I really don't know how I'm gonna set this up. Just store all of my stuff in here for now. Just grab a bunch of those casings to get it started. Until I figure out how I'm going to get them over to the other side. That for now, because oh, that's still full. Never mind. I guess I still need a splitter there. Guess I'm just not producing enough silica to keep those things running. Put the splitter on this side. Ah, put all my stuff away. That'll help get these things moving, so I'll actually be producing stuff again. gonna have to rework all this stuff at some point, because apparently I'm making 1,400 silica scrap at a time. But like, not nearly enough silica itself. Aluminum scrap, that's what I was saying. Even with all these, they can't. Oh, why is this not? How many of these are not actually set up? Just that one? That's weird. Just one of them wasn't working right. Alright, well, I'm getting distracted. I need to go set up a manufacturer for these parts. I may have to, I may be able to do it out here, which would be better, honestly. So I don't have to go all the way back to the base. This is the preferable one. I have to have rubber. Those need plastic. That's unfortunate. That's all pretty far away. Okay, there's pure quartz here. And the oil was over here. Man, this is going to be a much bigger project than I was thinking. So, if I do this one, which is 4.5 per minute, rubber's really easy to make, plastic's easy to make, if I have oil. That I make plenty of. I make 112 per minute of that, so that's not a big deal. Barely making enough crystal oscillators at the base as it is. Oh man. It'd be kind of a hassle to bring quartz over here. But I already have iron plates being made pretty large quantities down here. What to do, what to do, what to do. Alright, let me set up, let me go put these things back until I figure out what I want to do here, because it's going to be a bit of a challenge. I have enough copper to make the wire down below. Oh, all my fuel's in the thing. One 12 times 4 is 448. I'm making so many of those right now. Okay, so I would need to make nine refiners. Plastic. Problem is, we have it set up to make an unbelievable amount in the oil biome right now. So it'd probably be the most beneficial thing would be to set up trains to ship everything. Because if I could just ship stuff by a train, it would solve all my problems. I wouldn't have to build a whole nother production line. Okay, so technically I could manufacture crystal oscillators out here. I have a copper and iron nodes right where I'm at right now. That could make the wire and the plates, because I'm already making a ton of plates. So having it set up to make a bunch of wire wouldn't be that difficult. And quartz. I have a bunch of quartz that I'm manufacturing and not using. So I could bring that over here. I'd have to ship the plastic and rubber. From the oil biome to here. So that'd be, I'd have to build a train station over at the oil. I'd have to build a train station at the ports. that would allow me to make these. Man. It's a lot of stuff just to make those. Too bad they're not closer together. Okay. So I need at least two train stations, four freight platforms, five because I need the one at the main base. I have to run railway from the main factory to the oil biome. Oh, it's going to be a lot. So I guess first things first, I should take the train to the main factory. Have some back there where we just were, but okay, so this is where I need to put a train station for quartz, right here. I can ship that over there and then set up refineries to make the quartzite shards or whatever. Somehow I need to rework this station. This has to go all the way to the oil biome. So it might be easier to just do something like this. Oh, wind keeps catching my door. It's a little frightening. Oh. That's not good. Reason why I'm running it parallel with these lines is because the goal will eventually be to replace these lines with this track, so... Why is it curving now? Oh yeah, I know. Look, I know it's not pretty, and it's a pain in the butt, but hopefully this track will replace these two lines, so I won't have to worry about having plastic and rubber shipped by a conveyor belt anymore. Figure out where I want to have this track end at. I don't know if it's faster. I think the conveyor would probably be faster, but it's a pain to just run conveyor belts everywhere. So I think it would just be easier to have the train moving the stuff. And, you know, it'd be good just to have transport over here so I don't have to walk all the time. I mean, I think technically you can have the trains be more efficient than conveyors, because you can have like 27 cars or some nonsense like that. But I need to be able to move plastic and rubber without having just conveyors running across the entire map. So I figure a train would be a decent way to solve that problem, but I don't really know for sure. I'll probably have to wait until Zach gets in here when he's not working to be able to give me a better insight onto the best course of action for this. Let's see. Probably should just make a platform here. Oh, that needs to be taller. Shoot. This is mostly just a
I strongly advise you to harvest.
Yeah, it can only run one type of resource, whereas a train could fill up with all the different types of resources and just push them. Now, will I be able to push enough resources to be able to do this efficiently? I don't know. I may end up just running conveyor belts. Because while I can do a lot of resources at once with a train, I think in the end, just a conveyor belt system will probably end up being what I do. I may just have to build all the refineries and factories and stuff to make this piece over in the aluminum area, and then just not have to worry about running all this stuff by a train. Because the train is pretty complicated, and just conveyor belts is pretty simple, so I'm not really 100% sure what I'm going to do with this situation. That's why I'm pretty much just connecting a train, because it's something I know I can do without having to do too much extra work. Thank you. And it's something that kind of needs to be done anyways to have a train over to this section, so... Oh, I never grabbed computers! Oh, you're kidding me. I made space in my inventory and didn't grab computers. Farts. Well, at least I have track out here then. You can only summon the train if you have a station. I can't just, like, go to the track and make the train come to me, unfortunately. I need to build a station to do that. And to do that, I need the computer parts that I forgot to pick up. I really wanted to have, like, a nice, pretty factory, but I think the amount of time it would take for me to actually make something that complicated would be more than I'm willing to invest. Oh yeah, for sure, dude. Don't worry. I'm still learning too, man. Like, as you can tell, I haven't done anything really efficiently. I'm kind of just like throwing stuff together just to see how it all works. Probably should fix the train station over here that I disconnected. Before I run all the way back over there, because I can just take the train over there now that I have a track. Okay, so there is a way to make a split. All right, man, for sure. I was gonna call it here pretty much anyways, pretty soon, so. Good timing. All right, man, sleep good. Why won't you let me dismantle you? Ah. This might not be a good spot for this. Aw, you're kidding me. I'm going to just temporarily put it here. Why doesn't it want to talk? I don't know what's wrong with these trains. Okay, so at least it's working. Now, can I send it back? Alright, I'm just going to call it here for now. Figure out all this stuff tomorrow. Got to figure out how to make these radio receiver things. Maybe discuss it with Zach or Texan and see what suggestions they have. If I should just run conveyor belts or try to do it by train or what. But, as usual, I will be putting this up on YouTube as soon as I'm done here. Like, subscribe if you're watching over there. My YouTube link is in my bio, so it's a little bit easier now to be able to find it. It's Death Star on YouTube in case you don't want to go that way. I will probably be doing a... maybe a short stream tonight to play some Phasmo and see what that's like. But other than that, I will see you all tomorrow.